Danielle is clearly a mega talent. There's a reason why she's lasted so long. In this age where things are flying by mile a minute and whatever, Danielle's still standing, she still matters, and her music is fantastic. So, I mean, what more do you really want?
Say the name, Danielle LoPresti. If you don't know the name but live in San Diego, you know her work. Songwriter, performer, voiceover actor, teacher, an ardent human rights activist, and a devoted partner and mother. A passionate performer since her youth, Danielle was propositioned by several major labels in the 90s, but was told to change the message of her activist music. And after writing and performing the end title track for the biggest major motion picture comedy of 1996 and denied performance royalties and a spot on the soundtrack, Danielle knew someone else's record label wasn't going to change her fate. If she was going to speak with her own voice, she would have to do it herself. So she did. In 2001, she created Say It Records, and with her band, Danielle LoPresti and the Masses, the woman under the stage lights was musically driven to give voice to those who had no microphone nor stage.
The whole reason we do IndieFest is for bands like this that are so unbelievably phenomenal, and they deserve to be supported.
And she reasoned, if she was going to work this hard for her own voice to be heard, why not do so for other independent artists struggling to do the same? San Diego IndieFest was born.
Danielle really helped create an event and a scene that wasn't here before her, providing a really rich musical fabric and diversity.
She's the kind of performer that wants to take everybody with her when something good happens, and she has created a scene here that didn't exist before, doing shows at Humphrey's Backstage Lounge and doing all the community shows like that, and then of course bringing it to IndieFest, okay? That's huge, okay? There's a lot of people that talk big and are always gonna do this than that, but that's not Danielle. Danielle's a doer, okay? And she has more than backed up everything she said she was gonna do. She's brought it to the city. She's now made it something that everybody looks forward to on an annual basis. And I mean, for that alone, San Diego owes her a great debt of gratitude.
As a songwriter and performer, Danielle LoPresti has received acclaim from some of music's mightiest critics.
Danielle as a performer is awe-inspiring. To watch her is to watch the song coming to life. Her body language is just from a place within that, you know, you're either born with that or you're not. So she's inspiring for sure.
Dynamic power and charisma, I think, really are impossible to miss.
What I really liked about Danielle is that she's no holds barred. She's going for it 1,000%. None of this 100% stuff. You can hear it in every song, from the way it's written, to the way it's performed, to the way it's laid down on the tape. You know that Danielle's going for broke on every track, and it really, really shows.
As an activist in San Diego, Danielle's voice is also heard. From city council meetings, to music and arts events, and public demonstrations.
I'm sure that many, many people that were at various demonstrations know who Danielle was and saw her there, and it felt like she almost became a spokesperson for why Prop 8 was so wrong. And thankfully now the environment, I think, has changed, and if we had the vote, Prop 8 wouldn't pass today. But that wouldn't have happened if it weren't for people like Danielle really standing up and saying, this is wrong and we've got to change it. It's very rare to find in people, you know, you usually see them taking the path of least resistance or the one that's more convenient for them, and I've just never known Danielle to do that.
Especially with the community's young people, Danielle is dedicated to helping others find their inner voice and utilizing the power of that voice to fuel their own passions.
Danielle is incredibly unique if you look at her as an educator, because first and foremost, she shows up as herself. She's getting real with young people, which is the opposite of what they're exposed to a lot of the time. She makes it easier to breathe and easier to connect. And what she gives is so valuable in our time right now. To me, she's the kind of educator you can't pay enough. She's the kind of educator that's going to help this world change.
Earlier this year, on her 44th birthday, Danielle was diagnosed with stage 3 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. The cancer was based in a large tumor over her heart and had metastasized throughout her torso. All this just 18 months after the birth of her baby boy. For Danielle and her family, the news was devastating. For the last 8 months, utilizing both Western and Eastern medicine and healing techniques, Danielle has faced cancer treatment as she has with every challenge that's come before, with determination, compassion, and an unwavering focus on returning to full strength and health.
There is energy, and then there is force. There is resilience, and then there is unrelenting courage. There is tenacity in one's dedication to peace, and then there is an adamant refusal to tolerate injustice. There is the power of love and community, and then there are those who live in joyous gratitude of it. There are marchers, there are leaders, and there are prophets. And now and then, someone comes along who can pull off all three at once. With joy, unexplainable beauty, and deep, deep grace. It is with deep joy in my heart that I present this year's Durga Award to Danielle LoPresti.
Thank you, friends. Thank you so much. We're going to sing for you now. Matt. And I don't know how much I have left in me, but I'm just going to give you everything I got, okay?